of the United States of America, and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good morning, Cougars. Welcome to SCTV News for Tuesday, October 26. I'm Jack Fazer.
And I'm Derek Chisano. It is day two of Double Ribbon Week. The members of Club Rise and Pink Ribbon Club are teaming up to raise awareness about breast cancer and also encourage Cougars to rise above influence of drugs, alcohol, and vaping. Today, we focus on Pink Ribbon Club and encourage you to check them out.
The celebration of Pink Ribbon Month started in October 1985, and ever since then, October has been a month to celebrate and honor survivors and to raise awareness about breast cancer and what it is.
Pink Ribbon Club meets on Wednesdays every week during lunch. During club, we spread awareness on breast cancer and how to raise money for breast cancer research. We also talk about volunteer opportunities and leadership roles for our club members. Overall, Pink Ribbon Club is important because breast cancer can affect anyone.
Meanwhile, Club Rise meets today at lunch in room E204. All students are welcome to check them out. Then, on Wednesday, make sure to attend the Natural High Poster Contest at lunch. Cougars will create posters to celebrate their hobbies and achievements that offer a natural high.
Tomorrow after school, you're invited to take part in the SD Knights tailgate. There will be a game truck, free pizza, and music. The event runs from 4 to 6 p.m.
On Thursday, we are having a red out, and all Cougars are encouraged to wear red to celebrate Red Ribbon Week. Then, on Friday, we are having a pink out to wrap up Breast Cancer Awareness Month. There is also a rally on the quad at lunch with a performance from Club Groove.
A belated congratulations to this year's homecoming king and queen. In case you missed the big announcement, here's what it looked like at Friday's football game.
1, 2, 3.
Cougars dress in different ways. Some come to school with designer outfits, while others grab anything that's clean. Diego Denisio asked Cougar staff and students how they make their fashion choices.
It varies from person to person, place to place, and it's no different here at Steele. Fashion, like your fingerprint, it's unique. Unlike your fingerprint, you decide what it looks like. All sorts of factors decide how you dress.
I wear hand-me-downs. So if my sister gives me something, I just got this from my sister-in-law just last night. I basically have a really basic way of dressing. If I have cute jeans, I'll invest in jeans. I'll pay decent money for my jeans, but then everything else is kind of like, you know, if it's kind of cute, I'll throw it with a pair of jeans and I'm good.
Now for some, it's not so much what we have in our dresser. For some people like Mr. Galero, there is a purpose behind the way they dress.
I dress the way that I do because it's what I'm comfortable in. I move around a lot at work, so I want to be wearing something that I'm comfortable and I don't feel stiff in. I also think what you wear is kind of it makes you unique, and so I try to dress in things that kind of like in my personal taste.
Some people try to send a message with their clothing. For someone like Jesse Jones, that's what it's all about.
It's for really to kind of make people question why they try to fit in, you know. My whole thing is to try to kind of stand out as much as I can, and I don't know, make people try to interpret their character into their clothing.
For SCTV News, I'm Diego Donizio.
Academic lead members, there is a mandatory lunch meeting in room D207 this Wednesday and Thursday for all new and returning players. And it is not late to join. The first match of the year is November 10th, and the team is looking for more freshmen and sophomore players.
That's all the news we have for you today. Have a great week. Rah-rah Cougars.
Cougar Pride.
Get some!